Good morning. Welcome to Fortunate Sunday 12. I want to apologize. Yesterday I said it was day 12, but then it was pointed out to me it was in fact day 11. So here we are, day 12. It's my birthday. It's going to be kind of a short day because I'm writing right up to the, we're in a third act, I think. But we're writing right up to the edge of the action, and then I'm going to stop. And I always stop at a place where something big is about to happen, generally speaking. I would never write half an action scene and then stop. It doesn't make any sense. It's like playing, I don't know, half a basketball game and stopping. You want to finish. And if you're into it, you're in the thrall of the action, of course you're going to want to take it to the very end, and the product is going to be better, too. So I like to isolate those scenes, and unfortunately today I only have probably about four or five smaller scenes of ligature to get to that scene. While I'm on the subject, I should talk about smaller scenes that are ligature scenes. Just because they're small scenes doesn't mean they shouldn't be good scenes. Every scene should be a really good scene, if not a great scene. It doesn't mean it has to have action. It should have some great dialogue in it. It should propel the, propel the plot and the screenplay forward. Every scene should be a good scene. Every scene should make the audience or the reader want to read on more. That's our job as screenwriters, is to figure out how to get rid of all the shoe leather. There can't be any just connective scenes, like he's riding on somebody, because I have to get him from point A to point B. Our job is to figure out the most creative and most fun, but realistic way, according to the tone of the film, to get our characters from point A to B every single time. And I stopped because before the, say, this giant final action scene, which is going to end the film, I stopped there because to me it is like a battle. And I approach almost everything like a battle. And this is like the night before, or when I'm writing here, it's the night before the dawn where the great battle starts. And there's always sort of a calm before the storm. And that calm is me stopping writing. And tomorrow I will start writing that battle. But even in that sense, I look at almost every day as a battle. And there's a battle plan. And sometimes I look at the battle plan and I look back and I see my supply lines are thin, like the branch I'm on is thin. I'll go back instead and I'll resupply those supply lines or reinforce those supply lines so that I can come back and go to the battle that I stopped at with greater vigor and greater success. So anyway, that's what's going to happen today, 12, Fortunate Son. happy birthday. And let's go see what happens, and I'll be back to you in not too long. Okay. Here we are. It was day 12. It just happened. Now we're right up on the edge of our protagonists arriving at the fortress of our antagonists, and I'm not sure exactly what's going to happen, but I know it's not going to be good for the antagonist tomorrow. So if I were him, I would be enjoying my final night. But you know, having said that, one thing important about screenwriting is never to set your characters up. Not in situationally nor in dialogue. For instance, when I'm writing, I don't know what, have any idea what's going to come out of the character's mouth. I have an idea of the shape and the direction of the scene, but I let everybody speak for themselves. And some writers I find, particularly at the beginning, they set their characters up. You know, it's almost like a mob hit. They're set up to be killed, or they're set up to be made fun of, or they're talked down to. They're described in ways that are demeaning, which I never do, or I try to never do. I try to make everything equal playing field, both in terms of description and the dialogue exchange. It's a chess match, and everybody is a good player. It's just that maybe at the end of each scene, our protagonist is a slightly better player, but I have to figure that out, you know. If they're going to come out on top, they have to be really smart, because the other guy is really smart. And the same thing is situationally throughout the script. To keep the audience interested, there cannot be easy solutions, and they cannot be set up solutions that the audience sees coming. And so I admonish you to always show your villains a lot of respect. Like, they need to be extremely formidable and extremely smart at all times, so much so that the audience says, gosh, I'm not sure how the antagonist is going to get through this guy because he's so good. So, and when I say antagonist, I don't just mean a human antagonist either, because I find that the screenplay writing is always scrimmaging against antagonists, but again, they're not always human antagonists. It can be an environmental antagonist, you know, it can be, the antagonist can be the protagonist himself, internal issues that they have, that they're scrimmaging against. But they are always should have some sort of complexity to them and an inability to see through the path that they're going to themselves take, because after all, they are individuals who have their own agency and their own will, and most of them believe that they're good guys, although in a lot of scripts and action scripts, let's be real, when people are human traffickers, they know they're human traffickers, and they don't think that they're Mother Teresa. But that's a whole nother story. So in any event, fortunate son, day 12, that's all she wrote. I'll see you tomorrow.